Ken Trahan with Lenny Van Gilder for SportsNola.com. The Saints winning 24-3 over San Francisco. Another week of practice ahead of their second preseason game this week. And Lenny, what's your take from the first game are a couple of things. Number one, the defense looked good. Of course, we know San Francisco's not very good offensively. Number two, avoided significant injuries, although you had injuries to Joik Bell and also to Johnny Patrick, a couple of guys who the Saints want to take a longer look at.
Absolutely. I mean, that's the biggest concern you have going in any preseason game. You want to come out clean. You want to stay healthy. So obviously any kind of injuries or things you're concerned with, hopefully neither one is serious and these guys can be back on the field in short order. Impressed with the defense. I mean, especially, you know, I think the difference that perhaps that defensive tackle position made as it related to the pass rush. You know, we saw Greg Williams kind of, you know, take the handcuffs off, so to speak, and let these guys do some things, which maybe you don't normally see in preseason, but I think he wanted to see what he had. And it was an interesting result because the time that Alex Smith was in there, I don't think he had time to barely set his feet, and he was either going to the ground or running for his life.
He got plastered, and Roman Harper on a bunch of corner blitzes was there on a regular basis. Of course, some other guys that performed well in the game, number one picks, Mark Ingram and Cam Jordan distinguished themselves well enough. Ingram more so, but then again, he's more noticeable because of the position that he plays. And there's Joe Morgan, not the Boston Red Sox former manager, not the Hall of Fame baseball player, but a Saints free agent getting a chance here. And the likelihood is he probably doesn't make this team. Darren Sproles was brought in to do what he was doing in that game to return punts. But I think as Sean Payton said earlier in camp, sometimes you're not playing for a roster spot here. You're playing for a roster spot in this league.
Certainly, and he is certainly one of those guys that could be a practice squad candidate. Now, we've seen guys return kicks in the preseason before, whether it was Rod Harper or whether it was Larry Beavers or someone along those lines. We haven't heard anything from them. So there could be preseason stars, but, you know, kind of, you know, not get too excited about him just yet, although he definitely had his moment in the sun Friday night.
All right, things to look forward to moving forward. Marcus Colston back at practice, and they held him out of last week's game as a precautionary measure, and that's good news. Obviously, he's their number one receiver by and large. Of course, the bigger news, the fact that Tracy Porter is back on the practice field, and this guy is absolutely ginormous. There's no such word, but I made it up anyway. Because when you look at their cornerback position, Jabari Greer, need him healthy. And if you have Tracy Porter, now Patrick Robinson, who's improving but is still just a second-year player, can be your third guy, and that's a much more formidable lineup.
And no doubt. And, you know, a lot of people were speculating that we might not see Porter on the field till right before the Green Bay game. Then Sean Payton said last week the hope was to get him back out there right after the Houston game. Well, now he's ahead of schedule even more. We might see him on the field for the Houston game as he was back out at practice Sunday afternoon.
And the other note, obviously, that catches the eyes and ears of many would be the fact that Sean Payton is talking about the right tackle position offensively being open, that it's a battle for the starting job. John Stinchcomb has been hurt. He did not have a very good year last year as compared to the previous year. Zach Strief's been here for a while. He's been that backup guy that you could depend on, a mauler type, not as good in space, but he's not on the blind side. He's on the right side, so clearly there's a message to be sent here, and I think maybe it's a wake-up call for Stinchcomb.
Perhaps it is. And, you know, here's the thing to remember. I mean, all of these guys are professionals, first of all. You know, we didn't know a lot about Jermon Bushrod until Jamal Brown got hurt. Bushrod stepped in and did a more than formidable job, got rewarded here a few weeks ago with a nice two-year contract. You know, Strief chose to stay here. And, you know, perhaps if Strief were to get the chance, who knows what would happen there. Now, obviously, limit your flexibility a little bit because Strief has become a blocking tight end. You know, I know the stories were out there when he did re-sign. You'll start hearing those words again that number 64 is eligible. But, you know, does Strief being in the starting lineup hurt your flexibility? One thing to remember about the rules on that, Strief could go in and out as a blocking tight end. If he were to slide out and try to play tight end and say Stinchcomb went to right tackle, Strief would have to leave the game before he could come back in. So it would disrupt your continuity there for him to be able to do both of those. If you're committed to Strief being your right tackle, it would change some things as far as your tight end position is concerned.
All right, outside linebacker position, Jonathan Casillas with a leg up. He played well in that open competition to try to find two starters. If not one, Shanley might be a starter already, but the competition is certainly there. Otherwise, moving forward, forward, second preseason game. Finally, what do you look for? Is there any one thing that you're looking at? More productivity from Drew Brees in the offense and playing a little bit more? Chase Daniel continuing to get more time and progress? What are you looking for?
Well, as competitive as Drew Brees is, he is going to be just an angry man all week after the fact that he was on the field for three series and they went three and out three times. I would not want to be in some of those meetings this week knowing the competitor that Drew Brees is. I would fully expect a much better performance and a much longer performance, obviously, out of the ones this week as a result.
Lenny, as always, thank you. We appreciate it.
All right.
And that's our Saints report here for SportsNOLA.com. Along with Lenny Van Gilder, I'm Ken Trahan.